Family means everything to Leon and Nina Merrick. As young children, the Holocaust survivors lost everyone and everything.
My daughter, my grandchildren, is the only relatives we have.
I am the only survivor of my family, so my grandson means a lot to me.
And he was on Nina's mind when she answered her phone a few weeks ago.
He said, "Hi, Grandma, how are you doing?" And I said, "Who am I talking to?" And he said, "Your grandson, Joshua." And I said, "Joshua never calls me Grandma. He calls me Safta."
Joshua lives in Israel, but the caller told Nina he'd been in Greece attending a friend's wedding.
Then he said, "Well, I am in big trouble. And promise you're not going to tell my parents."
So the story goes and grows. The caller was supposedly in jail because he wrecked a rental car.
"I am in big trouble. They would not let me go, get out of the country until I pay the damages." I said, "So how much are the damages?" He said, $3,500.
Nina then gave the phone to her husband, who pressed the caller for a number to call him back.
He said, "No, I cannot give you the number. I'm going to pay you back every penny. Don't worry. Don't worry. If you're not going to give me the money, then they're not going to let me leave the country." I said, "Josh, it just doesn't sound like you. You have to give me the telephone number, okay? Let me think, and maybe I have to talk to somebody." And he didn't want to give me the telephone number. And at that point, we got disengaged. That's it. No money.
Leon then called his grandson, who was safe in Israel.
To be able to exploit seniors and their love for their grandchildren is about as low as it comes.
Eric Friedman heads the Montgomery County Consumer Protection Agency. He told me the Merrick's phone call followed the four-step dance to the grandparent scam: establish credibility, emergency, and secrecy. Then exploit grandparents' natural desire to help their grandchildren.
We have heard from seniors who've wired several thousand dollars, $3,000, $3,800 to these crooks.
The age of social media is also making it easier for crooks to get information on a possible target, like here on Facebook, where millions come to post personal pictures and information to share with family. In the hands of a crook, that information can be useful to con a grandparent who isn't likely to have a Facebook page.
I don't know where do they get this information? I mean, that I have a grandson whose name is Joshua.
This is the most despicable type of consumer fraud we can see in this office. It's just one drop short of violent crime.
Grandparents aren't the only ones who need to be careful. Friedman encourages all consumers, never rush to wire money anywhere unless you know for sure who will get it.
Typically, wiring money is no different than handing cash to someone. Once they run away, the money is gone.
And the Merricks share their own advice after almost becoming a victim.
He had answers for everything, everything. But it is important for people to ask questions, personal questions, to make sure that this is their loved ones.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Montgomery County, Maryland.